Yo, YouTube, what is going on? We back with another video. For today's video, I'm going to be teaching you guys how I make my thumbnails and how other YouTubers probably make their thumbnails. Now, keep in mind, this is how I make my thumbnails. But guys, before the video starts, I'm doing another free shout out. I'm doing this for every single video that I upload. All you got to do is be subscribed to me and follow me on Instagram. So for today's free shout out, we got Famous Ray. He got about 800 some subs. I need you guys to get him to 900 subs. So basically for this video, the thumbnail of this video, I'm going to be showing you guys how I made the thumbnail of this video. The first step, the first thing that I did, you want to go and open the Pixar app. You open Pixar, you go and you open up the picture that you want to work on. The first thing you're going to do, this is very important. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to go to the tools button. And you're going to go to crop. And you're going to scroll all the way till you see YouTube, which is going to be on the right. And just adjust it a little bit so that it fits your liking, right? I'm going to do it about right here. Right here, right? And then you press apply. All right, now, the next step is, like I said, once you figure out, I want you guys to learn the app first, right? Learn the app, look at how other YouTubers do it, and put your own spin on it. Once you got your picture, right? You want to go to the effects tab, right? And you want to go to FX. Go ahead and click the FX. And you have two options. You can go ahead and press the HDR, right? Which you're going to get something like this. And just, and like I said, push these buttons. Figure out what looks good. Because like I said, it's all about you, what you like. What I like is not what you like. So go ahead and figure it out. So me, what I personally like to use is I like to use HDR2 or crisp or sharpen. So I go right here. Now, just for this one, I don't like the way HDR2 is looking. I like the way that HDR1 is looking. So look. Here's what I do. I go ahead and I press the eraser button at the top, right? And you press person. The reason I press person is because I do not want the background to have the HDR effect. Now, to make sure that everything is selected, the areas that you're selected, go over to restore and just, like, for example, my hand right here wasn't, I'm gonna change up the size a little bit, hardness, and I'm gonna manually do it because it didn't pick it up because a robot is doing it. So sometimes it's not perfect. Sometimes you're gonna have to do it manually. All right. Yeah, it missed a little bit. It missed the side of my face a little bit. That's all right. Go ahead and manually do it. All right. So press apply once you're done. Now, press apply. The next thing I like to do is we're going to go back to the effects tab. Is sometimes I like to add two effects. So sometimes I like to go all the way to the back and I press, like for example, I do sharpen. Like, look at how crisp the image looks when you press sharpen. Like I said, press these buttons out. Figure out what they do so that you can add your own spin to it. Or you can add crisp. I don't like the way this one's looking. Now, I like the way that sharpen is looking, though. So I might press sharpen, and I'm going to lower it down a little bit so it's not too... I'm going to increase it a little bit so it's not too much. And again, I'm only doing it for me. So as you notice, it only highlighted this. It didn't highlight my arm. So now I got to go into my arm and I'm going to press restore and I'm manually do it myself. Try to be as precise as you can. The more time you put into this, bro, the better your thumbnail is going to look, because in reality, the better your thumbnail is, the more clicks you get, the better your channel is going to be popping. Next thing I like to do, I go back to the effects tab. I go back to effects and I like to add saturation. So go ahead and click the colors tab and click saturation. Again, I'm only doing this for the person. So click the same eraser tab, go to person. It shows you what it highlighted. In this place, it only highlighted mostly my face. So go back to restore and do the rest manually.
Right here, zoom in if you got to and do it manually. Add a nice little, like, it makes the thumbnail more colorful.
For this specific thumbnail, I don't normally do this for all my thumbnails, but I want the background to be completely gone. I don't want the background to be there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to effects again and I'm gonna go to colorize. and I only want the background to be colorized. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna press that eraser button at the top the same way, and you're gonna press background instead. After that, notice how my hand is taken up. Go to the eraser. Erase all the parts that you don't want to be inside this part. So just erase it. It's gonna take a minute, but take your time with it, no rush. Once you have it highlighted up, you can click on it. You can change up the color a little bit. For this one, I'm feeling purple right now. I don't know why. Yeah, and I kind of messed up a little bit. So now, the next thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to start to add in some stickers. You go to the sticker tab right here, and you just search up, just go ahead and search up thumbnail, and just look around. Look around and see what you see. Now, for example, I can go ahead and add this little circle right here to it. If I wanted to, play around with it, but that's not what I'm going to do. I'm just keep looking around. Like I said, I'm making this off the spot right now, so I'm just being creative with it. Like this arrow right here. Let's delete this arrow. What I could do is I can have it go to the erasers tab. I can have it come into the back. So I press background. So basically what happens is it shows that in the back of me. And if you don't like the color of that, right? Go ahead and press apply. And you go to effects. And you can go to color. And you can go to color replacement. Right, change that to whatever color you want it to be. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I want to add a glow. To add a glow to your objects, you go to the border and you press whatever color that you want the glow to be. So for this instance, I want the glow to be, and then you go to shadow. Once you press shadow, you go to opacity 100%, blur 100%, position. You want to move everything to zero. After that, go to color, and you want to pick the same color that you picked. Boom. And it makes it look like there's like a glow going on or whatever. So, after that, I'm going to put a viewfinder. And to find the viewfinder that I use, I'm going to go ahead and put the link in the description. Place it right here. And that's it. Save this. I'm gonna save. I'm gonna download the picture. And we're gonna go ahead and open it up to Fonto. And we're gonna open it up in Fonto. And in Fonto, this is where I add the words. This is where so what I do is, I just click right here to add text. And the font that I use a Fortnite font. I'm gonna go ahead and again, link that in the description. Again, I'm gonna click on font. This is the Fortnite font that I use. And I'm gonna go to style. I like to go to pattern, change it from horizontal to vertical. And I'll pick the same color. See right here, see bam, same colors. So I'll size it up a little bit, and like I said, just mess around with it, guys. And you can go right here to style, and you can add a glow. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add this little thing right here. Change the size up a little bit.
So yeah.
Guys, this is a basic, simple thumbnail. As y'all can see, if you look, guys look at my videos, I have more advanced thumbnails. And it's a lot more complex than that. But this is simple, easy to be done. As you guys are doing more and more thumbnails, you guys will get more comfortable. This is simple right here. And that's it.